Today we are going to see about Azure Basic Class, Azure Overview. So what is subscription? So Microsoft provide 4 types of Azure subscription. They are free, pay as you go, CSP, enterprise, student. You need a credit card to start your Azure free subscription. They provide $200 with your subscription. During 30 days, whatever services Azure you can able to access without no limitation. After 30 days, you have to convert the subscription to pay as you go. Around 12 months, some services are limited, you can use it. After 12 months, some services always available, you can use it. So, but you have to convert it as a pay as you go. So, pay as you go subscription. Whatever services are you are using, you'll be billable. For example, I'm running my virtual machine for 20 days, so you'll be billable for 20 days. If you're using per day 4 hours, you'll be billable for 4 hours. So whatever services you are accessing and using, you'll be billable. CSP is cloud solution provider. They are partner of Microsoft Azure. They'll deliver to small to medium businesses. So wherever the business they don't have any cloud vendor, cloud engineer, cloud knowledge, they reach cloud solution provider. They offer Microsoft Azure subscription. So then enterprise account. Enterprise account you'll be billable for in upfront. For example, you are going to access some resources like instances for 1 year, 2 year. Or you're going to use some huge services for long term period, you can choose an enterprise account. So you have to pay upfront money, but the discount will be compared with the pay as you go around 72%. So this is useful for long term access, long term projects. A student account. So if you are having a student, Microsoft provide $100 for 12 months without any credit card. So public cloud, private cloud. When the services are delivered over the internet, that is called the public cloud. And if you are using in on-prem, that is called private cloud. Microsoft provide private cloud solution as well, that is called stack. Of what is infra as a service, platform as a service, software as a service? You know very well about on-premises, so you keep all your data, application, VMs, networking, so everything your on-prem. So infra as a service, storage, networking, compute provided by your cloud solution provider. On top of it, you are going to use virtual machine and what are the operators you are going to use, like 2012, 2019, Windows, Linux, like this. So here best example is infra service virtual machine. So you have to create a virtual machine on top of Azure provided storage, networking. So you use storage, networking, compute. Then you can choose which operating system you need. So when you go into platform as a service, here you should not worry about VMs and operating system management. So in infra as a service, still you have to manage your OS patch, and you have on top of you to manage your antivirus solution here. But when you go into a platform as a service, this will be taken care by cloud solution provider. You just to go and get application, you can use it, that's it. And software as a service, it's a popular service, so you should not worry about anything. You just to go and access your application like Office 365. So what is region? So region is nothing but data centers. The region having collection of data centers. So when you're going to create services like virtual machine, application, you have to choose your data center region. So you have to choose your data center nearest your customer place. So what is called the resources? Resources nothing but services. Whatever services you're creating, like virtual machine, application, storage accounts, they are called as services. So all the resources contain resource group. So resources are managed by resource group. So resource group exists only one resources, only one resource. So the resource group contains collection of resources. So this resource group used to manage your resources, like if you want to provide a rule-based access control, or else you want to delete the entire lots of multiple resources, like 1,000 resources, you want to delete just to go and delete your resource group, as well as if you want to provide role-based access control, like read access, full access, and delegate access, you can provide through this resource group. So subscription having a resource groups and resource group contain resources. Thank you for watching. This is very, very basic class. We'll see next class one by one all topics.